Hi there, this is our YouTube channel Biotech Amalgamated, and today we are going to discuss about recombinant vaccine which are used in poultry farming. Now in this video we'll see what are different types of recombinant vaccines and how they are prepared in a laboratory or a commercial scale. We'll see one example for each type of recombinant vaccine. Now first of all, what is vaccine? Vaccine is nothing but the biological preparations which provides us acquired immunity, hence to fight against the infection. Now these infections are caused by different bacteria and viruses. So you have heard in news that due to certain kind of diseases, the poultry farming has faced a lot of loss in their business. So even though already conventional vaccines are present in the market, but then too there are some disadvantages of using conventional vaccines. Later we'll see later what are the disadvantages and how the recombinant vaccine can overcome that disadvantages. So a recombinant vaccine is nothing but the vaccines which are produced through the use of recombinant DNA technology, and this recombinant DNA technology involves the insertion of DNA segment that encodes an antigen into another bacterial or mammalian host cell, so that that segment of DNA will express the protein in the host cell, and those expressed proteins are purified and used as a vaccine. So these are the three types of recombinant vaccine. First one is subunit recombinant vaccine, attenuated recombinant vaccine, vector recombinant vaccines. Now we'll see these three different kinds of vaccine in a diagrammatic manner here. Suppose this one is a virulent bacteria which has a n number of surface receptor on its surface, and we have found out that these surface receptors are encoded by certain kinds of certain segment of DNA. Now once we find out that this blue color segment of DNA is encoding this surface receptor, so we'll take this blue color segment and clone into a suitable vector, and then this segment of DNA will be transferred and inserted into the expression vector. Once a suitable construct is formed, just suppose this is a expression vector containing a transgene in it that encodes a surface receptor of the bacteria. Now we'll transform the host cell with this construct, and once the transformed host cell produce or express this segment of DNA, then the expressed proteins can be purified and used as a vaccine. And the second example is second type is attenuated. So in that, what we'll do, we'll take the same segment of DNA and mutate those that segment of DNA and insert back into the bacteria. Now what will happen? As earlier, we mutated a particular segment of DNA, so that surface receptor will not be expressed on the surface of bacteria. That means this virulent bacteria is no longer able to infect other animals or cause infectious disease, because surface receptor is not there. So what we did, we converted this virulent bacteria into a non-virulent bacteria, and hence we attenuated, we changed. That's why we called it as a attenuated recombinant vaccine, and we can use it as a vaccine. And the third type was vector recombinant vaccine. So in vector recombinant vaccine, what we'll do, for example, let's say this is a non-virulent bacteria or a virus. We took a gene that encodes surface receptor of this bacteria. These two are different, okay? So we took gene from this organism and inserted into genome of this non-virulent bacteria. Now what will happen? This non-virulent bacteria will express this surface receptor on its surface. So it will act as an antigen and it will create, it will provide us acquired immunity when we use as a recombinant vaccine. Remember, we are combined this gene into this genomes of this organism. So this bacteria will act as a vector, hence we call it as a vector recombinant vaccine. So these are several diseases by which poultry farming gets affected, and it results in huge loss in business. So this Newcastle disease, Marek's disease, infectious laryngotracheitis, this three are caused by viruses, and the protozoal diseases such as coccidiosis, histomoniosis, and bacterial diseases such as streptococcal infection, Remorella, and anatype estifor. As I told earlier, that this recombinant vaccine overcomes several advantages of conventional vaccine. In that, first one is it eliminates the post-vaccination reaction. That means we have experience when we get vaccinated in our arms or over our body, at vaccinated site, we get a swelling or redness or itching, or even sometimes we get fever. So this recombinant vaccine eliminates these all post-vaccination reactions. And second one is it eliminates the need for booster vaccine. Booster vaccine means we have to take once in our lifetime and that's it. It will work over our life. And it provides excellent immunity, of course, because they are live in nature. And the fourth one is lifelong immunity. Lifelong immunity. And fifth, it's easy to administer and lack of spreading live virus in the field. Here, the fifth one is very important, because remember, recombinant vaccines which we are using, it's a mutated form of bacteria, or it carries DNA from other virulent bacteria or virus. So this bacteria can be identified by taking the sample from vaccinated animals and from non-vaccinated animals, because we can easily differentiate between two, because vaccinated animal will be have in the mutated or recombined strains in their body, whereas the infected or non-vaccinated animals will not have these recombinant strains in their body. So these are several examples for recombinant vaccines. First one is a herpes virus turkey that carries Newcastle disease viral protein. And if you are using this vaccine, then it will provide immunity against Newcastle disease. And fowl pox virus that carrying infectious laryngotracheitis viral protein, fowl pox virus that carrying avian influenza virus protein will provide their immunity against their respective diseases. So this one is the example for the subunit recombinant vaccine preparation. In this example, the NDVF gene, where I have obtained from NDVF genome isolated from Newcastle disease virus, and M1 gene, that is matrix protein, that codes matrix protein, were obtained from influenza virus genome. Now this both genome were cloned and then inserted into a backmid, where this backmid is a baculoviral genome. It's a defective one. Once we'll insert these both genomes into this backmid and insert it into E. coli cells, those E. coli cells will multiply in numbers in a culture. And remember, I said that this backmid is a defective one. Why defective? Because when this backmate is inserted into E. coli cell, it will act as a cloning vector. It will not act as an expression vector. So once this backmate is multiplied in a enough number of quantities, now that backmate is isolated and inserted into baculovirus, and this baculovirus will infect the insect cell line. That means we use it for infecting the insect cell line, and this insect cell line when get transformed with this backmate carrying these two foreign genes, then this insect cell line will express the antigenic protein, and that antigenic protein can be purified and used as a subunit recombinant vaccine. Now this one is example for the second type of recombinant vaccine, the attenuated recombinant vaccine. Now here we'll study how we can prepare attenuated recombinant vaccine for infectious laryngotracheitis virus, which is caused by Galid herpes virus. Now for let's say we'll isolate the viral DNA from the Galid herpes virus, and then we'll modify the gene encoding pathogenic protein. Now in this case, glycoprotein I and D is encoded by segment of a DNA, and that's will mutate that segment of DNA and insert back this genome into this cell, Galid herpes virus. Now remember, this Galid herpes virus is now mutated one, and it will replicate its mutated genome in each replication cycle. Now this Galid herpes virus can be used directly in a live form as an attenuated recombinant vaccine. Now remember that this infectious laryngotracheitis disease was caused by this, because of the proteins in pathogenic protein synthesized by Galid herpes virus. Now this virus can't produce this the pathogenic protein. So hence we have converted the pathogenic bacteria into non-pathogenic. So this was the example for attenuated recombinant vaccine. This last one is the recombinant vector vaccine. Here we have taken the H1N1 backbone, and backbone in the sense we have isolated H1N1 genome. In that H1N1 genome, we have inserted hemagglutinin gene, which was obtained from H5N1, and a neuraminidase gene, which was obtained from H2N3 virus. These two genes were incorporated into H1N1 genome. Now this construct is inserted into H5N3 virus. Now remember, this H5N3 virus is acting as a vector, because we have inserted this gene construct into its viral cell. Now this virus can be used as a vector vaccine, and reverse genetics has also been used to prepare vaccine against foot and mouth disease, classical wine fever, and Newcastle disease vaccines. These are the references. You can check it on the whatever things I have included in this video. And I hope you understood this topic and you liked it. Bye bye.